Everyone else seen that film? It's great fun. Welcome back to another episode of Music Club. It has been a little bit while since I've done one of these. Sorry again. I'm really struggling to find a consistency. The Who the Fuck series has been great fun. But it's been a good 3 weeks since I've done one. So I'm back with another episode of Music Club to talk about the first one of 2019 and talk about three records that I'm literally obsessed with that have come out in the last few weeks, maybe. Kind of recently, let's say. There's some incredible music coming out this year. I just want to start by talking about some news that I read this morning. Bombay Bicycle Club are back. They're back rehearsing. They're going to do some new gigs. That clearly means they're going to be back in the studio at some point. Praise him. We've got some new Frank Carter coming out tonight. The Brexit vote is tonight. We shall see what happens there. And all is good in 2019. What a lovely start to the year. Let's walk through what I've discovered so far. It's Friday. It's sunny outside. That can only mean one thing. Music Club. The first band I want to talk about today is the return of a band that I fell in love with from the first moment I heard them. I think I came across them during a Mike's Down session in one of Zane Lowe's old Radio 1 shows. Their debut single, Homesick, quickly took me to one of those kind of obsessive levels. And in 2014, I became even more obsessed with them with their debut album, The Balcony. Catfish and the Bottlemen are made up of four members: Benji, Robert, Johnny, and Van. They're a super popular indie band from Llandudno in Wales. Well, actually, I wouldn't call them indie. They're way more Britpop. They remind me significantly more of bands like Oasis. This record in particular it sounds like it was written for Liam Gallagher. And they also remind me significantly of the Stereophonics. Sweet, that should be better. And they also have serious influences from the Stereophonics. I'm pretty sure in a previous interview, Van mentioned that Rango was ripped directly from Bartender and the Thief. Definitely. In 2016, they released their follow-up album, The Ride, which went to number one in the UK album charts. Other accolades include winning the 2014 BBC Music Awards. Didn't know that was an award. Nominated for three NME Awards, and won the Brit Award for Best Breakthrough Act in 2016. But since then, they've kind of maintained radio silence. Well, not radio silence, they've been on tour. They've basically been on tour non-stop, actually. They've been playing loads of gigs. They've recently just finished an Australian tour. They played a few festivals last summer. But last week, you may have seen my reaction in the albums of 2019 list. They announced that they were releasing new music. Oh. Is Catfish and the Bottlemen? Hint at a big announcement coming next week. And last Monday, that's exactly what we got. They're back. They're working on a third album, which they recorded in Wales with producer Jackknife Lee. Previous work from Jackknife includes Chasing Cars by Snow Patrol, If I Just Lay Here, Not In Love by Crystal Castles, and my personal favourite, Waiting for the 718 by Block Party. Block Party fans know. So we know they're in good hands. I've been following them from a really early stage in their career. I went to go see them really, really early on. I think it was literally the week they released Rango as a single. I saw them play the Louisiana and Bristol. And as they gained more and more success, there was always this fear that that would get to them and that they wouldn't be the same great band that I fell in love with. I know my girlfriend, Lauren, that was certainly a really big problem for her. She really struggled with the second album, and I think with their success, it became, it's something that happens when you listen to music, right? It's your little thing that you discover, and then all of a sudden someone else loves it and you're like, hang on a minute, I discovered that, and you're not getting the recognition for it. So you start to not like them. But this record, Lauren started playing it the other morning, and even she turned around and said, it's really good. In an interview with Radio X, Van explained that Longshot was taking a chance on something and it paying off big time. And the chorus of the song felt the same way. However, Lauren and I were discussing the day in the car. She said that we would use the word maybe instead of could have. But it's not our song, so we'll let them off. It feels great to have Catfish back. And with festival season just around the corner, perhaps we will really begin to see them smash it. I've said for a long time they're destined for the main stages, and I think that if this album's successful, I think we'll start seeing them next year. Let me know what you think about this one. This is Long Shot by Catfish and the Bottlemen. Listen, the distance between us, could it took a while once we close that difference, you turn up like a friend of mine. Every once in a while, the little things make me smile as if. One of the best things about making these videos is the community that it started. I did something recently that I've never done before, and that was to start listening to recommendations from people in the comment section. I'm super particular about who I take musical recommendations from. It's something that I've got a thing about it. I need to change that. I'm working really hard. But whilst I was doing one of my Reading videos, this guy popped up in the comment section over and over again. And before I knew it, his track Polaroid was being played on Beats 1. Kodak moment, Polaroid picture, shake it, yeah. And I started getting recommended tracks on YouTube. The rare time that the algorithm actually works. Slow Tie is an MC, a UK MC from Northampton. Not much musical history from Northampton that I'm aware of, that's for sure. He has this sound that's almost eerie, is the way I would describe it, and lends itself way more to a punk crowd than I would say that like a grime crowd would. He's really pushing the boundaries of what it means to be a rapper in the UK, something that I think even America is struggling with at the moment. I think it was Pitchfork or I think it was The Enemy that said, his tattoos, close-cropped hair, and tangled mic cord conjure images of hardcore punk frontmen rather than hoods-up grime MCs, as he spits scouring lyrics over rough-edged beats that recall Boy in the Corner era Dizzy Rascal. I think this describes his sound perfectly. It's something that in the grime world at the moment, there was this real cool, scary, dark, aggressive side to grime, which I think is taking a little bit of a break. I first started hearing that with Dizzy Rascal and Boy in the Corner. His song Polaroid in particular significantly reminds me of I Love You by Dizzy Rascal. But just as I thought I discovered a Dizzy Rascal 2.0, something that I would be really happy to discover, I come across his latest record, a collaboration with the incredible Muramasa. Let's talk about Muramasa for a second. Muramasa released his debut album last year. Or was it the year before? I think it was 2017. And I really struggled to connect with it. It was just a little bit too poppy. There were some records that he did that I loved. I thought that it were brilliant, but the rest of it seemed a bit too poppy for me. But every so often, he comes and hits the nail on the head, and this is one of those times. Tracks like this get me really, really excited. I would love there to be like a whole subgenre spawn out of this. Grime MCs over punk riffs. That's the kind of sound that I would love to hear. In fact, it would be really cool if we could start getting like punk remixes of grime tracks. That would be amazing. This in particular, it reminds me of a more kind of hardcore version of Jamie T. It's a bang bang Anglo-Saxons in the disco with tissue all fall down. And similar to the work of Show Me the Body, specifically the song Trash. It's really aggressive, but really, really tasteful. Last week, it was announced that Slow Tie actually made it to the top 5 of the BBC shortlist for Sound of 2019. He made it to number 4. An accolade that I think will give him significant success this festival season. I'm sure we'll see him at Reading and Glastonbury. And it will be really interesting to see how his sound develops. I think this song in particular is great. I'd love to hear more like that. Polaroid's great and his kind of traditional grime sound is fantastic, but it would be really, really cool to see something more come of this kind of startup thing. Him and Massa should just do like an album together of cool stuff. That'd be great. This is Dorman by Slow Tie featuring Muramasa.
Nicotine, can't quit it. Two's up, two's down. You stop it out before I finish. On my arm and I scream out wow.
And the last record I want to, oh god. And the last record I want to talk about this week is a song that I also came across by listening to Annie Mac's show last week. Following her hottest record by Bring Me the Horizon, she did like an hour, half an hour metal rock mix. And she played this beauty. I've just watched the video for it. It's mad. And the record sounds for me like the love child of Royal Blood. And The Prodigy. Their Facebook page describes them as a no-holds-barred oral assault on anarchic electro-psych-punk noise that is something like Death From Above and the Chemical Brothers' bastard offspring. I like that. Genre-wise, they describe themselves as future punk. I also really like that, especially as there's this kind of electronic dance element to their music. Future is a word that's used to try and describe every next subgenre of everything in every dance record ever. So the idea of having future punk works really well for what they're making. It's what you would hear if rock and metalers were making electronic music. A lot of the time you can hear the electronic influence in a lot of these bands. Let's look at people like Linkin Park. Bring Me the Horizon, they both use a lot of synths. In extreme cases, people like Enter Shikari. They're using samples and synth leads around very, very heavy rock music. But this is still designed to be played live. This is still designed for the stage. And dance music tends to be made for DJs. It has a different approach. It follows a different structure. It's designed for energy. It's designed to captivate a crowd in a different way. And this record in particular sounds like a rock band trying to make a record for the club. And it makes me want to visit that club. I've never actually heard anything quite like this before. I think the closest we've ever come to something like this, I mean, The Prodigy do a good effort, but they're still a rave band. But I think the closest we've ever come was with Pendulum. But I feel that was more a diversification and evolution of the drum and bass scene. They still made drum and bass and dubstep and house records. They just added guitars and put it on a stage. This, for me, feels like the other way round. If anyone knows any more bands or music or people that are doing this, please just let me know in the comment section, because I'd love to do a mixtape of stuff like this. That'd be great. They're made up of two members, Space and Vibe. Hilarious, I know. And regardless of if this is a scene that I've been missing out on or a new subgenre at its conception, it sounds so good. The energy and the hype is brilliant, and I'm really excited to see what happens next with them. This is Trance by Black Futures. So that's it. That's three new songs to add to your library. There's some seriously good music around at the moment. I'm really, really excited for what's happening in 2019. If you'd like to know more about that, I would highly recommend watching my Albums of 2019 video. There will be a follow-up to that soon as well, I feel sure. This week, for now, that's that. We've got the Lurt album coming out on Friday, which I'm super excited for. And New Bring Me the Horizon and Swimmers also coming out soon. Foals have got a new album coming out in March. That's really exciting. There's so much around the corner. I'm literally so excited for this year. If there's anything that you think I should be checking out or have missed, just drop me a little comment, that'd be great. Songs and artists, always appreciated. But until next week, have a lovely time. I'm away this weekend, it's my birthday, so there may be a little bit of a delay with next week's video, but I might go and record it at the beach down in Byron this weekend. That would be nice. It would also put all of you people who are back home in cold England very jealous. So look how lovely it is here. Like, the sun is setting and it's super lush. Look at that blue sky. Anyway, thank you so much for watching this video. This channel is growing and I love it. Thank you so much. So if you have been watching my videos, honestly, it means so much to me. There's a few of you that always comment and watch, and I really, really, really love that. So thank you so much. And I will see you next time. Cheers, bye.